You know, the Bible states that Satan was the head of music in heaven. He uses famous people to help influence the world. Once you make a certain amount of money, some say that's when he asks you to join his empire. To get to his empire, you have to accept the beast worship. And once you join, he helps you with your career and make you a star, but only if you agree and obey to destroy God's plans. The price of fame always comes with a cost. This episode is about the singer Houston, who was once on top of the world until the music industry gave him a nervous breakdown. Now, Houston Edward Summers IV was born on October 26, 1983 in Belize. His family ended up moving to Los Angeles, California, and he enrolled into Alexander Hamilton High School and Academy, in which other celebrities you may know graduated also from there, like Nipsey Hussle, Layla Ali, Tiny Lister, Paula Patton, Omarion, and many more. Now, while in school, Houston would display his musical talent to staff members and classmates by singing freestyles, while everybody else would instead be rapping and singing material they had written down. Once the school took notice, seeing that his talent was on another level, they convinced Houston that he was a star in the making, and he began winning talent shows in his community. Now under a management team, one of his managers sent in a videotape of one of his shows to Capitol Records, who liked what they saw and signed him to a recording contract. Now, once he got to Capitol Records, Houston was ready to show off his talent, but the label had their own agenda on how to market him. They began giving him songs that was already written by other songwriters and dressing him like artists that was popular at the time, in which he didn't really agree with the image they wanted him to have. And in March 2004, he released his first single, I Like That, featuring Chingy, Nate Dogg, and Ludacris artist Disturbing the Peace, I-20. The single peaked at number 3 on the US Billboard Hot R&B Hip Hop Songs chart and number 11 on the Billboard's Hot 100 and the UK Singles chart. The song also charted in the top 40 in countries like Australia, France, Italy, New Zealand, and Switzerland, pushing that single to certified gold. McDonald's even picked that track for a television commercial that featured an on-screen cameo from Justin Timberlake. His debut album, titled It's Already Written, was released on August 10, 2004, which also went certified gold. Now a full-fledged star, Houston began traveling across the world and touring overseas, but at some point became fed up and disgusted with the music industry and just wanted to get out. The things he's seen and witnessed made him think twice about being an entertainer. And on January 27, 2005, while on tour in London, England, Houston suffered an emotional breakdown and reportedly tried to commit suicide by jumping from a hotel window. Now, some say he was under the influence of PCP at the time. Now, the story goes that after the people in his crew stopped him from jumping out of his hotel window, he was restrained and locked in a first floor room. But while in that room, Houston gouged his left eye out with a plastic fork. According to his bodyguard, he said he went to check on him before he went to bed and saw blood on the floor. He saw Houston lying on his bed with a towel over his face. And when he removed that towel, he discovered Houston's left eye hanging out. The bodyguard also stated that Houston told him that he had to get the devil off his back, and that's the only way he could kill the devil. He found himself in the midst of a spiritual battle against the evil industry. After that incident, Houston was arrested by London police and was put in rehab for 2 weeks. After the rehab, he went home to Los Angeles and apologized for that incident. Houston claimed that the Hollywood music industry was trying to make him do things he didn't want to do because he was raised strictly Christian. Now, according to Houston about what happened to his eye, he said that he got his eye injury from dealing with certain thugs, dealing with certain gangsters, and dealing with a certain mafia in the industry, and he had to get out of the industry for a second and take a breather. He eventually left the music industry and got off Capitol Records, and now has started a campaign he calls Stop the Sodomy and Gang Rape, in which he plans to put an end to inmates raping other inmates in the prison system. Houston also says he's putting a message out there and wants every man, regardless of color, to ride with him on this new campaign. Whether you white, black, or Chinese, he wants to stop the sodomy of the system, because there's an innocent man being raped every day in prison, and hope he can push his no gang rape policy. Now, years later, sometime around May 2012, he was busted for a DUI when cops caught him driving out of control near Malibu. The DUI charge was reduced to a minor traffic infraction, and a $100 fine was suspended. Let's pray for our brother Houston.